Welcome to PC Mac. Today we are going to start a new series about DietPi, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can install DietPi on your Raspberry Pi 3 Model B Plus, and after that I'll show you how you can move your installation from your SD card to the external storage device. It can be anything like a flash drive or a USB hard drive. You can move your installation and you can use that external hard drive as your primary device, primary storage device. So let's do it. First of all, let's just go ahead and open the website for DietPi. So when I'm going to type DietPi here and search for it, it will give us this website, DietPi Lightweight Justice for your SBC. When I'm going to open it, it will show us this particular website. Then we need to navigate to download, and it will take us to the download option. So we require Raspberry Pi here, and you can see all the available boards here for this operating system. If you're using any other single board computer, you can download the image from here. The tutorial will be same for every SBC. It will not be different, but I'm using Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. So I'm going to click on it. When I'm click on it, it will open this menu. You can just click on this download icon. It will open this download link for you. When you click on it, it will download the image for you. The image is really small, around 17 MB. So it will not take that much of time to download. I have already downloaded the image, so I'll show you. Now I'm going to navigate to my download folder, and here you can see when you download the image, it will look like this. Let me show you the size of the image. It's around 85 MB, and when you extract this image, you need to use the 7z. When you extract this image like this, extract to DietPi, it will open like this, DietPi v6, and it will around 628 MB. After the extraction is done, it will be around 628 MB. So let's go ahead and flash this image to our SD card, and closing these boxes now, and plug in my SD card to the computer. Now the SD card is plugged in and it asks us to format the drive. Let me just cancel these options. Now I'm using the SD card formatted to format the SD card. Let me go ahead and open it. So when the SD card is open, it will automatically detect the SD card. That's the D. And when I'll click on format, and yes, it will format the SD card. I'm using a 16 gig of SD card. As you can see, the capacity 14.63 GB. Let's click on OK. Close it. Now I'm going to open Archer to flash the image to the SD card. Now we need to select the image from here. And here is the image, the IMG file. And the SD card is automatically selected. Then we need to click on flash to flash the SD card. Flash this image to the SD card. It will take a moment, so I'll be back. So the image is successfully flashed. So I'm going to close it and unplug the SD card and connect it to my Raspberry Pi. So the device is turned on now. I have connected 32 gigs of flash drive for the spectacle to my Raspberry Pi, and I have inserted the card as well. Now to check the IP address of a Raspberry Pi, what we need to do, we need to open the wireless network watcher to check the IP address of our Raspberry Pi. So it will scan my network and check what all devices are connected, and it will generate the IP address in a moment. Once you turn on the DietPi image on Raspberry Pi, it might take around 1 or 2 minutes or up to 5 minutes to turn on the image or to boot the operating system. So we need to wait. So here is our DietPi. Raspberry Pi Foundation 192.168.1.73. Now what we need to do is open the PuTTY and access the IP address 192.168.1.73 and hit open. It will take us to the command line interface. We need to log in with the root and the password is DietPi. That is the default password. I need to type it again. So I'm logged in now. As you can see, it's initializing. Let me move the window to the middle of the screen. And as you can see, this is the license agreement. This program is free software. And the whole thing is right here. So what we need to do is we need to press OK. And then it says, do you want to adjust the default global password? So it's good if you are going to reset your password to your choice. So let's go ahead and do that. We need to type the password 2 times. Now the Unix password, will change this one as well, as we use the default root password as DietPi. So this will also change. So I'm going to change it. So the passwords are successfully changed now. It will take a moment to just check everything and then it will take us to the console. And as you can see, it's checking the space and it's checking the updates as well. So once the update and upgrade is finished on DietPi, it will ask you to opt for a survey or you can exit from the survey. So just select exit and press the tab button to go to OK and hit enter. And it will be done in a moment. And it's done. As you can see, DietPi has been updated to the latest version. System will now reboot. Once completed, simply log in to resume DietPi setup. So let's go ahead and press enter. It's restarted the Raspberry Pi now. Let's click on OK and wait for a moment. And then I need to just right click here and then click on restart session. So once I'll do that, it will ask us to click on yes and then log in with the root and the new password. So I'm logged in now. Let's click on OK. Now we are in the configuration. From here we can go ahead and configure our DietPi. So the second thing that we need to do is move the DietPi user data from the SD card to an external storage. So I'm using 32 gigs of flash drive. So what we need to do, we need to navigate here, user data location, and hit enter. Now from here we just need to click here, select for a list of available, and before doing that we need to go into drive and then click here. It will load all the drives that are connected to the system. So the drive that we have connected is not mounted yet. So this is the path of that drive. We need to hit enter to access this drive. We can directly mount this drive from here, or if you want to format this drive, you can just select format. So I'm formatting this drive and press OK and press OK again. It will take a moment to format the drive. So depending upon the size of the drive, now as you can see, the default and recommended path is this. So you can also change the name. So let's go ahead and change the name and name it as store and press OK. Now as you can see, previous mount source and the new mount source is store. So let's press OK. Now it's done. We just need to go back, and as you can see here, the capacity is 29 and it's mounted now. So let's click on exit and OK. Now before doing that, what we need to do is just click on install to install the packages and click OK. So it will install the minimal image on the DietPi that contains all the necessary packages that we will require in future to install the other applications on our DietPi. So it will take a moment, then we will transfer this data from the SD card to the external storage drive. Now the minimal setup is done. As you can see, server unexpectedly closed network connection. Let's go ahead and press OK. And as you can see, the system will now reboot. This complete the DietPi software installation. So the minimal operating system is installed on the Raspberry Pi. Let's go ahead and click on restart session. And again login with a new password. And then we need to go into DietPi software. Now we can easily change the SD card to our external hard drive. Let's move to SDEMMC list and then select MNT store. Okay. And okay one more time. As you can see now, user data location is custom MNT store DietPi user data. Now we need to go into OK and press OK again. Then back and exit from here and OK. So this will conclude the setup of DietPi and moving the data from the SD card to an external storage drive.
So guys, that's it from my end.
If you like this video, please go ahead and subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. If you have any questions, you can write them in the comment section. I'll try to answer them. And thank you for watching my video. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.